Good morning, everyone. I am down in the lower corner of the video screen. Hello. It is 10 after 5 a.m. I just got home a while ago. I'm quite tired. I've had a lot of things going on the past 24 hours. I'm just dead tired. For those that tried to contact me yesterday, especially in the early evening throughout the night, I was unable to. My phone system was down because the Hydroelectric Corporation was working on the transformers in the area, and they had to cut a lot of the service for a while. So I apologize. If you need to contact me, especially in an emergency, if you're not able to get through my home phone, my cell is 1-207-702-2151. Again, I apologize, the circumstance is out of my control. And unfortunately, it might end up being that way this morning as well. They're still in the process of working there. In the past 24 hours, I've traveled extensively. And I've been doing some research, legal-wise, on behalf of my wife, Donna, at the Stillwater Healthcare. And in conversations and meetings with my attorney and the Attorney General's office, I've begun procedures to file a federal lawsuit, which actually is going to include six other individuals in the form of what's called a class action suit against Stillwater Healthcare and the affiliated associates of Eastern Maine Medical Center Healthcare. So hopefully I'll be able to know more as time goes by this week and throughout next week. I don't know the circumstances, and I'm prohibited from going into details until the paperwork is actually finalized. But I will say that if you are a family member or a close friend, I will try to explain as much as I can, as best as I can, but please also understand that I can't go into complete details yet. When the time comes, then I can. But right now, my only concern, instead of my main concern, is the proper care and supervision of my wife, Donna. She's in a position medically where she can't do that herself. So it falls on me as her husband and as her power of attorney, power of healthcare, and spokesperson to see to it that her rights are not being violated and that her health is not being jeopardized. That's the sole reason for this class action suit. Again, I can't go into detail, only to tell you that once it goes into the court system, it's going to be quite extensive and most likely very lengthy. The value amount is, in fact, in excess of $500,000, but it's not for me that I'm doing this. It's for my wife, and any funds that possibly could be awarded will go directly into her account, not mine. This is being done because, let's face reality, she's the one that ultimately ends up suffering when nobody speaks up on behalf of her. And it's not just her, that's why it's a class action. There are many patients there at the healthcare facility that either have dementia, Alzheimer's, cancer, or a combination of whatever condition exists. So basically somebody needs to stand up and fight for these people. These people are elderly, these people have lost the ability to live independently, and they rely on people within their families to protect them. And that's exactly what it is. It's protecting them. When you have instances such as what happened to my wife, it really puts a strain on how much protection you can give. I'm not trying to ramble on this video, but I just want to air this because it's really something that's important. And my message for anybody listening to this, whether you're family, friend, acquaintance, or just somebody listening to the video or watching it, if you have somebody that's in a hospital setting, a nursing home setting, or a health setting, regardless if it's rehabilitative or short-term or long-term, or a combination of all of the above, please do yourself a favor, check on the ones you love, your family, your friends that may be there, see to it that their needs are being met. Don't just ask a staff member, are you caring for the one I love? Because most likely, and don't get me wrong, this is not judgmental, but most likely they're going to say, yes, we're doing the best we can, and that may not necessarily be the case. Please check whoever's there for bruises. Check for any signs of abuse, because a lot of people don't want to hear this, but the reality is elder abuse inside rehabilitative centers, nursing homes, healthcare facilities, it does happen. Just recently, I noticed a very large bruise on my wife's shoulder, and I started questioning how that bruise got there, and I was not given a direct answer. So I set up a automated webcam. I didn't tell the facility this. I did tell my attorney, and I had to notify the police department. And where it was done through an investigative service, some of the information that was obtained on this tape, on this video, was turned over directly to the Attorney General's office. So let me emphasize again that abuse inside these facilities do take place. Unfortunately, it's more often than what people are told. You don't see too many videos on YouTube, Facebook, MySpace, etc. that goes into that. And I think that's a shame because people need to be made aware. That's what this video is about, is just to let people know it happens frequently, and it's not just somebody else. It could be you, it could be somebody you love, it could be just an acquaintance that you've known for a while. It doesn't matter. That shouldn't matter at all. The fact of the matter is they deserve protection, deserve proper health, and they basically deserve their rights to be met. What I'm saying is quite simple. Just check on it and go from there. On a different subject, I've been spending a lot of my free time going over paperwork, and I've noticed a lot of things that I didn't really notice before. Mostly about myself, my attitude, my general overall attitude towards life in general. Since Donna's stroke back in May 5th, of this year, I've been actually forced to take a look at myself and see where I am in life. I realized that being a married man to my wife, and where my wife is not here, the temptation for me to seek out certain activities obviously is human, but I've had to actually set that aside. And I don't mean sexual activity, don't get me wrong, I'm not indicating or even going there. I'm very faithful to my wife. But activities such as getting back into the drug scene, I've been smoking a lot of weed recently, and I don't hide that. Even the police department, all the police department know that I smoke. And an occasional drink now and then. The thing is, I'm a recovering drug addict alcoholic, so I'm afraid that if I continue that, it's going to put me back into a position where I get into a reliable situation. In other words, become reliant upon drugs and alcohol. That would be very unfair to my wife, and that's why I'm mentioning on this video, because every now and then I'll actually watch my own videos, listen to what I say, and let it serve as a reminder. For all my family and friends, if you see that I'm slipping into the drug and alcohol scene again, please let me know. sometimes I don't realize that I've spoken so much, and I actually am afraid that it's going to continue and get worse. And I'll be the first to admit that scares me, because I know the kind of lifestyle I lived when I was growing up. I lived a very violent lifestyle. I grew up on the streets of the Bronx, and I became a drug and alcohol dependent person for a long time. And it literally took my wife to straighten me out, to get me to realize that it's killing me. All right, well, I rambled on in this video, and I didn't mean to, but the issues that I mentioned to me are very important. I hope they're important to you. And again, as far as the healthcare facility and abuse and treatment and rights, please check on it if you have somebody that's in a facility like that. I can't emphasize enough the importance of that. My name is Alan, this is Bangor, Maine. It is almost 5:30 in the morning. I'm going to grab a hot shower, unwind, perhaps a quick breakfast, and I've got to get a few hours sleep because this afternoon I have another really hectic afternoon planned. So again, if you call me and my home phone is not active, or if it's out of service for a while, my cell is 1-207-702-2151, and I look forward to hearing from you. Have a good one, everyone.